Welcome back friends once again, and in this video tutorial I am here to discuss about the inflammation or inflammatory response. So first of all, let's discuss what are inflammatory response. Whenever a pathogen try to infect us, they first of all breach the outer barrier of innate immunity component, that is skin and mucous membrane, right? And then after tissue injury caused by that breaching induces a complex series of events, and those complex series of events are known as inflammatory response, right? So inflammation can be of two types, acute and chronic. There are five hallmarks of inflammatory response, and those are swelling, redness, heat, pain and loss of function. Now let's discuss about the mechanism of induction of inflammatory response. So just after tissue injury, vasodilation does take place. Now what's the meaning of vasodilation? Increase in vascular diameter, okay. Increase in vascular diameter means vasodilation, and what it causes? It causes rise in blood volume in the area, and due to this high volume of blood, tissues gets heated up and color becomes red, right? Now, vessels become more permeable or vascular permeability gets increased, and it leads to leakage of fluids from the blood vessels, and it results in edema, means accumulation of fluid. It swells the tissues, leukocytes starts to adhere to the endothelial cells in the inflamed region and pass through the capillaries walls and into the tissue spaces. And what this process is known as? This process is known as extravasation. And then after, what leukocytes do? Leukocytes phagocytose the invading pathogens and releases molecular mediators such as cytokines. And what is the role of these molecular mediators? These are having role in inflammatory response and activation of effector cells. Now see here, step by step the process is being given. First of all, tissue damage causes release of vasoactive and chemotactic factors that trigger a local increase in blood flow and capillary permeability, what I have told you just now. Then after second step, permeable capillaries allow an influx of fluid, that is exudates and cells, okay. And here you can see the permeability of the capillaries does increases, and exudates containing complement C reactive proteins does come out. Then after, the process of extravasation does takes place, and after that neutrophils and other phagocytes, they just migrate to the site of inflamed region or inflammation, that is the process of chemotaxis. This process is known as chemotaxis, and they phagocytose the antigens or bacterial cells. So phagocytes and antibacterial exudate destroy the bacteria. So this is all about the mechanism of inflammatory response or inflammation. So thank you with this. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel.